We are going down to our next tool, and in fact, I want to play around with this just a second. I don't know how, but we ended up with a long and skinny toolbar, and we want the double wide, so I'm going to just pull it out here for now. So we've gone through the line tool. Now let's go to the shape tool. The rectangle tool, the oval tool, rectangular primitive, oval primitive, and polystar tool. Let's just play with these and see what we get. So the rectangle tool, as you can guess, is the rectangle. Now you'll notice one thing. If I zoom in, we have these round edges on the rectangle. Well, where's that coming from? I'm holding down my option key and zooming back out to see to show you something. Remember how we just created this line, this stroke with the line tool, and we fattened it up. Well, if you look, if I delete the fill, we can see that the line has remained from the previous line tool drawing that we did. So if we double click on this, go back to our properties, and we say, okay, I only want it to be one, and I want it to be black, then every shape that we now draw is going to keep the last selection that we made for the rectangle that we create. So that's a good thing to keep in mind when using the rectangle tool.